Now for some music. I spoke to the singer Jason Prince about his career and recent success.
Hi Jason, you just got back from the States.
I've just had the most incredible experience in New York. I've just spent nearly a month there staying with the lovely Eileen Shapiro, who is the A&R lady for Trax Records, and I've just signed to Trax Records, which is a Chicago record label, actually.
Fantastic.
Yeah, the label that started house music as we know it today. Mm-hmm. It all stemmed from Chicago, Frankie Knuckles, and all these legendary producers and DJs. That's where house music started in the club scene, the early club scene, and the New York club kids. Rachel, Screaming Rachel, who owns the record company Trax Records. She was one of the original club kids with Michael Alley and all this, James St. James and all the original club kids. Of course, you know,
you got a couple of singles out. One had a massive amount of hits straight away in the States.
Well, I recorded a cover version of "Wouldn't It Be Good" by Nick Kershaw.
Mm-hmm.
Originally, we did a Euro version of it because I was doing some stuff for a German label last year.
Mm-hmm.
And we made it very high energy, very Euro, very what Jason Prince is known for. And then my co-producers, Scott, Jose and Nick C, said, you know what, I think they'd like this in America. We should try and do some different remixes of it and see how it goes. I even went in and re-sung it in the new style, and we did like a very sort of a contemporary ballad type style with this song, and very much like what you know, Sam Smith or someone would do, who's massive in the States, you know. And the song worked really well like it, and then they did some house remixes as well, and that got the interest of Trax Records, which is why I've ended up releasing the single with them. And it just straight away had a large amount of streams in the first 3 or 4 days before I'd left America. I was notching up the streams, which I'm pleased about.
Fantastic.
And now Love Is The Only Law, which was my original song that I wrote with the with my friends on our 50 Years Legal song that you've reported about before, when we had our 50 celebrities on it, UK LGBT celebrities. I re-recorded that solo for Stonewall. And our original actually has just hit 45,000 streams, so I'm quite pleased about that. But I recorded my own special version for Stonewall, and it's being used as the promotional song for the Simon Napier Bell book.
Mm-hmm.
50 Years Legal, which celebrates, you know, UK and also 50 Years Stonewall.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
So where we're standing at the moment in Shoreham, this is where Leo Sayer was discovered. He lived here on the houseboats behind you.
Yeah.
How do you feel about that?
Oh, I mean, Leo Sayer's a legend, and I was on his side when he left Big Brother, okay? I was on his side. The guy is an international superstar, and it's only a TV programme. He did have the right to leave at the end of the day. And this is lovely here, because I used to have a reoccurring dream. It's very similar to that, actually. I used to have a reoccurring dream that I turned a houseboat into a recording studio, and everyone would come on, and all the artists would come on and record their songs with me. Because we've got a studio in London, Club Kids Studio at Barbican, and we spend most of our life underground. No windows, you know, because we've got it all soundproofed in the basement.
Yeah, yeah.
So, and I thought, well, if you had a boat and you just went out to sea a little bit, you wouldn't have a problem with noise.
You'd be a pirate then, wouldn't you?
I would be a pirate producer. It would be like Radio Caroline all over again.
When are you in Brighton again?
I'm in Brighton again. Well, I've come down today,
mm-hmm.
Especially to see you, actually. But obviously, I always come down to visit Maisie. I'm thinking about popping down for Brighton Pride. My friend Sandy from the Sandy Assange from the Gogglebox.
Mm-hmm.
She wants me to come down with her.
I'm
not performing this year at Brighton Pride. And the Prides, it's a strange one. It's a strange one with the Prides. Us sort of gay scene artists, they seem to sort of rotate us around the Prides, and because every town now has a Pride, doesn't it, through the whole country?
Yeah.
So I tend to do about, I don't know, about 6 or 7 Prides a year, but a lot of them all on the same day, so you know I just tend to choose one.
Yeah.
Each Saturday through the summer. But I'm not doing Brighton this year, but I'm actually off on that day in the daytime, so I think I might just pop
come
down
and join
have
us
fun,
come
yeah.
down and see us. So are you going back to the States? I mean, now you're getting your name known there, you're getting successful there, you're getting lots of hits there. What's going to happen?
Well, I'm very excited because this journey has just started only a year ago. in New York when I first hooked up with Eileen from World Star Beyond Tracks. And in a year, you know, it's just so much has happened. I also went to LA in between, earlier on in the year, with my friend Ollie London, who's one of our artists at the Club Kid Studio. And we actually recorded a song with him, a K-pop song, and it's ended up becoming the first ever UK or European or Western artist ever to go into the top 40 of the K-pop chart. And he's already had 300,000 streams of our song, so we're very proud of him. So I went to LA with him, and we were filming a reality show which comes out in December. And and they're expecting multiple million viewers on the reality show. And I'm there as his producer, his BFF. And so when that gets broadcast in December, I'm tempted to go out. I'm tempted to go out there again for
I don't
December.
Blame you. Thank you so much for joining us today. We'll see
Thank you,
again
you
soon.
Mike.
All the best.
I'm Mike Mendoza for latest TV news.